a big scare during the final shoot of the film of Men and Mavericks over the weekend. One of the film's stars, Gerard Butler, was hospitalized Sunday after he got pulled under by a set of big waves and had to be rescued. Now, he's okay, but it had to be really scary. He's pretty much a beginning surfer, and he was out there where the big boys play. Action News reporter Phil Gomez talked with some surfers who were actually in the water when Butler went under. Were they scared, Phil?
Well, it didn't appear so at that point, Dan, but they were very concerned about the whole thing. You know, filmmakers were working on a shot of Gerard Butler paddling out at the legendary big wave spot with local surfers Greg Long, Zach Wormhout, and Peter Mell when a round of rogue wave caught them.
Zach was actually coaching Gerard. He said, hey, relax, take two deep breaths right before we go underneath this thing. One of the things that happened was that his cord got ripped off. So he lost his surfboard.
While held underwater for two waves, a safety patrolman on a jet ski reacted quickly and picked him up as he was being washed through some rocks. Once ashore, Butler was taken by ambulance to nearby Stanford Medical Center, where he was briefly held for observation and then released. Butler was shaken, but not seriously injured.
Me and him kind of had this eye-to-eye thing. We were like, okay, you know, he didn't have a surfboard. And I was sitting there, hey, we're cool, relax. You know, we're going to have one more wave here, buddy. We're done.
Butler plays a lead role in Of Men and Mavericks as Pleasure Point surfer Frosty Hessen, mentor to Jay Moriarty. Moriarty was a Santa Cruz surfer who burst on the Mavericks' big wave scene at 16 and died in a free diving accident at age 23. Butler is not an experienced surfer and had not surfed much prior to filming of the movie.
I think the fact that he's a movie star is irrelevant. I think it's just all about whether you can surf those kinds of waves.
If you're a good surfer, even if you're in top of your form, it can take you at any moment out there. You know, it's a really heavy wave.
Big wave surfer Shane Desmond just happened to be surfing at Mavericks when the rogue wave struck.
You're kind of doing some real basic stunt work, what it seems like, and Mother Nature just comes out and just whoops you one, and all of a sudden you realize how powerful she really is and how dangerous that surf spot really is. And, you know, he actually was not really acting in that moment. He kind of got a real taste of what happens out there when you're surfing.
The film was shot in Santa Cruz in October, and in recent weeks around Pleasure Point and Capitola, filming for the movie has ended, but there will be secondary shots taken after the holidays, so you may see film crews around then. Just none of the stars.
There you go. All right. Very good. Thank you, Phil. Of Men and Mavericks is due out next October, and the opening ceremony for the Mavericks' big wave competition, by the way, is scheduled for Sunday, January 1st.